my beautiful astrology soulmates, and welcome to your weekly horoscope for the week of August 24th, where this week, I'm going to tell you, I think it is a week you have to watch what you're doing and plan quite carefully. We've got some interesting squares happening, and then we've got Venus taking two different oppositions this week. We've also got Venus trining Neptune, which is great, and it creates a nice, artistic, easy energy, but it also brings like a lack of clarity to the table. Now, Mercury is looking fabulous this week, so that is definitely good news for us. This week is also a very busy week over here in the Eat and Greets. We've got the week starting with Laura Nalbandian. On Tuesday the 25th, Michelle Knight will be over here. Clarissa Dolphin and Nora Rochelle will also be here this week, so it's a busy week in the Eat and Greets. So while you're trying to feel through the buzz that is life this week, you can come over, sit down, and have a great creative conversation with us over here. All right, jumping off right in the beginning of this week on the 24th, we've got Mars, who's not yet retrograde, but is in shadow. So he is slowed down quite a bit, but Mars is over here in Aries, and he's going to come into a square with Saturn, who is retrograde. So now you have the energies of Aries and Capricorn, respectively, squaring and putting pressure against one another. Now this is happening at 26 degrees, so you can go ahead and chart that in your chart and see what that means. Now Mars is like that child energy. It's forceful. I want to move. I do what I want, you know, and it's running up against Saturn, who, even though Saturn is retrograde, Saturn is still that more authoritarian parent energy that says, no, no, you're not. Now Mars thought he was cute, and he's like, oh, I'm going to try and run and do this thing while Dad's asleep, right? But Saturn still retrograde, has got parent eyes. He's like, no, I see you in the back of my head. You're not going to just push this forward. So what this brings the attention to for me this week is this idea that Mars is like, let's push, let's go, let's go, let's go. Something has got you ready to go and to push forward, but you're being stopped under this square because Saturn is literally squashing the fun. He's like, hold on. I'm not trying to stop you from going to do what you want, but I want you to slow down and consider if this is the best grounded decision. Have you thought this through? Saturn is retrograde. Rethink, re-edit, re-examine, re-evaluate if this is the best thing. Think about it. Is this the best movement for you? This is an Aries. This is Capricorn. Practicality, taking on Aries the warrior. Is this the best plan, strategy, tactic? Have you reviewed this enough to know that this is a solid plan going forward? So right here in the beginning of the week, it can feel like a tough energy, right? Because you try to sneak up one on Dad and that's not working out. But it is also an energy that I think can be quite helpful and beneficial if we will review the plans of what's going on. Now, this is only one of two squares that these two are going to do together. Okay, so we're going to see this energy again this year. But for today, let's just do this one first on Monday. Now, as we get to the 25th, we've got some movement. It's a busy cosmic day. Mercury is going to be in a trine to Uranus, who's retrograde. So Mercury's over in the energy of Virgo, happy, at home, doing his thing, living his best life. Uranus is retrograde in Taurus, where he's not as comfortable. Now, this is all happening at 11 degrees, so chart that out as well. Now, as these two come together, this is still a trine, right? So Mercury trining up to this retrograde Uranian energy is like, well, hold on. I've got these new ideas or new thinking on old situations. I've got some innovation. I've got some electric ideas. Maybe you're even, this is the day where you're speaking just out of your mouth, or you're making plans and you're kind of this gangster planner. You're doing something, you're really thorough, you're really effective, but you're doing it in a way that's really different than maybe what you've been doing before. You could be going back to something that you've already been working on, something in your structure. Taurus is an earth energy. This is a material plane. Your money, your relationships, and you have a much more prioritized, succinct, step-by-step view on how to handle these things. Now, on the same day, we've got Virgo, we've got Venus opposing Jupiter, who's also retrograde. So now we've got an opposition between the Cancer-Capricorn axes, and we've been working in this for a couple years. So again, this may not be showing you something that's brand new, especially because Jupiter is retrograde over there in Capricorn, and this is happening at 18 degrees. This could be something you've already been looking over. So the combination of these energies today really speaks to a speaking up, about what's going on in your environment, what's going on in your world. I feel like this Venus, even though it's in opposition, which usually is relational, but can feel very internal, right? I think that this is an energy where Venus is trying to have Jupiter be light. They are both benefics. And when Jupiter is retrograde, even though he's retrograde, he's still a benefic. So as they oppose each other, I think Venus is like, I don't know. I want to be at home. I want to be here. I want to be light. I want to be easy. And Jupiter is over there retrograde in Capricorn. And he's like, we can't. The wisdom of why we speak to authority, the wisdom of why we have the structures that we do, the wisdom of why we do what we do. You're in a pull this week, right? You know, and a big thing I think of, here we are, we're watching it in the news. Do I vote? Do I not vote? Right? This is a big question that's on the table for a lot of people right now. But where else do you see this dynamic between I want to stay at home and be good and be lighthearted and warm and be in the mood over here versus what I think I should be doing out there or what I feel called to be doing out here in this particular area? Now we get to the 27th of the week and we've got Venus in a trine to Neptune, who is also retrograde. So you see, we still have this theme of retrograde this week. The world is not happening quickly out there. We are still in a relatively slow pace. So we've got Cancer and Pisces, both water energies, in this trine here at 20 degrees. Now I do like this. This is creative. This feels like, you know, the stars are just a little bit brighter. You know, the things are just a little bit juicier, a little bit more tasty. It's glamorous. There's a collaborative, creative spirit here. And it's wonderful. It's airy. It's in the emotions. It feels good, but it's not making things super clear. This can actually create a pocket of ease to avoid or to pull away from. So I do want you to be mindful this week that this week is still requiring response and step up for us. And while it's got this magnetic, optimistic pull to it, we have to just not take it to the place of hiding and isolation, right? It's more so an energy. Okay, let me step back. Let me see the positive, optimistic side of this, or the creative third option in decisions that we're trying to make, right? Maybe there's, you've only been able to see it two ways. What's the creative third option? That's a beautiful use of this energy this week, I think. Now, as we're coming to the end of the week on the 29th, we see Mercury over here in a trine now to Jupiter, who's retrograde. So Virgo, Capricorn, Earth sign happiness at 18 degrees. They are dancing together. Now, this is actually, I feel like personally, if you needed to travel, if you needed to do something like that, I think it's actually a really great weekend for doing that, getting these last minute before school, in quotes, trips out of the way, go see something different. Maybe this is a weekend you feel like writing, speaking, pouring your words or pouring your service into something. And it would likely be with Jupiter here in retrograde Capricorn. Truly, I feel like you're going back to speaking to some very powerful authority in your life. But the way that you're speaking it out today has this incredible, incredible sense of service. This is heightened positive thinking. It is heightened, grounded in the material world, practical level thinking. So you've really got Mercury on a little bit of fire here in this particular energy, but in Earth energy. Now, as we end the week on the 30th, we've got Venus again in an opposition. So we see Venus opposing Pluto, who's retrograde. Now, this is going to happen Cancer, Capricorn, axes again. This is at 23 degrees of Capricorn, okay? Now, Venus opposing Pluto here, It heightens our need for intimacy. It heightens our need typically for affection. It brings an intensity to our relationships, to our finances, to the things that we feel value in. But again, in this Capricorn energy, it's like what's right for my home and what's right for, you know, my government, what's right for me, what's right for my family. It's definitely this home self-care, taking on what I should be doing level opposition. So I'm telling you, as you're planning and you're making your decisions for what's going on this week, I want you to realize that sometimes too, Pluto and Venus get together, and because of the intensity of this opposition and the pull, It can, this particular one can feel like there's a little bit of a crisis on the table, and it's moving you to see something in a light that you could not see before, right? Now, we're going to move next week into this full moon energy in Pisces, and I think we get to see everything meld together under a lot of light, but it may feel like that pull starts here on the 30th. And then as we arrive at the 1st or 2nd, depending on where you are in the world of September, you're really seeing this light up between what's the self and what's the obligation on the other side, and where you're doing a little bit of regeneration there. So I would tell you, it might not be as helpful this week to make huge plans that you can't see kind of where you need to go. What I mean is, take it step by step this week. Allow Virgo season to pour over us under all of these aspects and these configurations for the week. And let's take it step by step and take a minute to step back and see if what you've done has made sense, right? Does this make sense here? Can I sustain this? Ask those questions as we go through the week, especially around your relationships and your finances, okay? All right, you guys, I think it's going to be an absolutely beautiful week. I look forward to seeing and finding out what's happening for you all week. I can't wait to see you in the eat and greets. I'm over the moon about Michelle Knight. She's coming over for the eat and greet, but we have also talked about future collaborations as well, which just has my whole heart lit up and on fire. So I can't wait to share with you this week. Please share with me in the comment section down below what's happening for you. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you. Oh, and the autumn equinox gifts are out a little bit early, so if you click underneath this video, they're already down in the description box below, okay? I love you guys. Bye, everyone.